Mike Montgomery uses the same glove he wore 2 years ago when he induced Michael Martinez to ground to third base and secure the Cubs' first World Series title since 1908. Some of those memories will be there forever, and rightfully so, said Montgomery, who returns with his Cubs teammates Tuesday night to Progressive Field in Cleveland for the first time since beating the Indians in Game 7 of the 2016 World Series. "It's trying to balance remembering and enjoying that year but also knowing you can't stay in that year the rest of your career. Last year was a good lesson." Talk of a World Series rematch faded last October as the Dodgers humbled the Cubs in 5 games in the National League Championship Series and the Indians blew a 2-0 series lead in losing an American League Division Series to the Yankees. "We realized the World Series title was monumental and how difficult it is to get back there, even when you have a great team," said Ben Zobrist, who had the game-winning hit in Game 7. "These young guys keep learning and growing, and they're better than they were a year ago. They're hungry, and it just reminds you and whets the taste buds for another championship." The World Series title earned manager Joe Maddon a $1 million increase for each of the final 3 years of his contract. But Maddon still owns the same tablet computer he used to look at the weather report while Jason Hayward delivered his spiritual speech to teammates during the 17-minute rain delay before the 10th and deciding inning of Game 7. The Cubs' dramatic win alleviated some of the criticism directed toward Maddon after some questionable moves. Maddon remains firm in defending his logic throughout Games 6 and 7. "His only regret," he said, "was not getting closer. A role as Chapman out of Game 6 sooner after the Cubs expanded their lead to 7 runs in the top of the 9th. Maddon had summoned Chapman, who threw 42 pitches in Game 5 2 days earlier, to retire Francisco Lindor with 2 runners on to preserve a 7-2 lead in the 7th. "There's no Game 7 if you don't win Game 6," Maddon said. "The only thing I did wrong was I didn't get Cheppy out after we blew it open, because I had that in my mind to do it, and then I didn't." He threw 4 extra pitches, walking Brandon Guyer. "Too much is made of that." Despite an obvious dip in velocity, Maddon called on Chapman again in Game 7, and he allowed Rajai Davis's tying home run in the 8th. The homer baffled Maddon because Davis choked up on the bat and appeared content just to poke the ball. Game 7 also featured the oddity of John Lester, in a rare relief role, bouncing a pitch off the mask of David Ross to allow 2 runs in the 5th, as well as Javier Baez fouling off a bunt attempt with 1 out in the 9th and Hayward representing the go-ahead run at 3rd. But the steep steps from the clubhouse to the field will bring back fond memories for Maddon, who recalled giving post-game interviews on the field, "and it's raining and you don't care," reliever Carl Edwards Jr. remembers, cameras every 2 steps, and waving the W flag before hugging his girlfriend and daughter. "It was crazy stuff," Edwards said. Being on the mound for the final out, Montgomery knows how lucky he was to be in the center of professional sports' longest-awaited celebration. "As soon as I can afford to buy a house and figure out where I want to live," he said, "I'll create a room that has a lot of this stuff." M. Gonzalez at ChicagoTribune.com. Twitter at Mint Gonzalez. Javier Baez plays role of enforcer in Cubs win. Cubs working with Yu Darvish to solve his 5th inning struggles. Cubs hold on for wild win over Rockies after Chris Bryant.